In this tutorial, we will take a look at setting up the airplane for an ILS approach and complete an approach brief. The first step in preparing for the approach is to request the weather and find out what runways are in use. Based on the direction we are arriving from, we can get a good idea of which runway to expect and legality to make the approach. We will set up the FMC and then follow up with a general setup. On the departure and arrivals page, select or verify the expected approach and transition if appropriate. We are expecting runway for right in Boston's Logan Airport, with the Goshi transition on the Roebuck 3 arrival. On the legs page, we check the legs match those on the approach plate. We now create a 2-mile ring around the final approach fix for situational awareness during the approach. We now enter the runway length for the heads-up display, using landing beyond threshold distance if shown, or displaced length from no TAM or ADIS. We also verify the glide slope angle and elevation. We select flaps 30 and brakes 2. We can now use the chart's briefing strip to set the remaining items. Starting on the left of the strip, we can set the ILS frequency. Moving right, we can set the inbound approach course of 35 degrees on the MCP. After checking the final approach fix altitude, we can set the decision altitude of 218 feet. We can now brief the approach, which would sound like this.
What are your threats for the approach?
Busy airport, with low ceilings and gusty winds. I've also only been there a few times.
Thanks. I agree with those. To mitigate your threats, I will answer any questions you have, and make sure you have time to complete tasks during the approach. Okay, today we are flying the ILS to 4 right at Boston Logan Airport, chart 11-1, with a date of April 14, 2023.
That is the chart I have as well.
The frequency is 110.3, that's set twice. The final approach course is 35 degrees, milt at 1,700 feet, down to a decision altitude of 218 feet, which is also set twice. The touchdown elevation is 18 feet. MSA is 2,500 to the southwest, and 2,000 feet in all other quadrants. It'll be a flaps 30 approach, with brakes 2. The runway has ILS 2 lighting system, with PAPI on the left side. The runway is 10,006 feet long, longer than our landing assessment, and we'll plan a left turn off, with one or more runways to cross. The airport has multiple hotspots depicted. If we go missed, we'll climb to 3,000 feet and head out to Waxen where we'll hold as published. Do you have any questions or additions?
No, neither, thank you.
We hope you enjoyed watching a typical ILS setup, followed by an approach brief. Be sure to review and include chart notes when applicable. Please subscribe to learn of our future videos.